Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject air compressor. And this is lecture number 7 on air compressor. We are going to solve problems from the Anna University question paper in this lecture. In the earlier lectures, we discussed the theory part of the reciprocating compressor and we solved problems from Anna University question paper. We take few more problems from the Anna University question paper in this lecture. Example number 11 from November 2012 question paper. A single acting two-stage air compressor deals with 4 meter cube per minute of air at a point 1.013 bar and 50 degrees Celsius with a speed of 250 rpm. The delivery pressure is 80 bar. Assume complete intercooling. Find the minimum power required to by the compressor and the bore and stroke of the compressor. Assume piston speed of 3 meters per second, mechanical efficiency 70%, volumetric efficiency 80% per stage. Assume polytropic index of compression in both the stages to be n equal to 1.25 and neglect the clearance volume. So the given data we write down. So single acting two stage compressor, the volume of the air handled by the compressor is 4 meter cube per minute, which is 0.067 meter cube per second. Inlet pressure is 1.013 bar. Temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. Speed equal to 250 rpm, which is 4.17 rps. P3, delivery pressure is 80 bar. Piston speed is 3 meters per second. Mechanical efficiency 0.75. Volumetric efficiency 0.8. And n equal to 1.25. Polytropic index equal to 1.25. First, we calculate the stroke length. From the piston speed, we calculate the stroke length. Piston speed equal to 2Ln. So, the stroke length L equal to piston speed divided by 2 into N. So, 3 divided by 2 into 4.17. 4.17 is the speed in RPS, revolutions per second, which is 0.36 meters. Actual volume of air delivered, V equal to pi by 4 D square Ln into volumetric efficiency. So, the 0.067 volume of air delivered is given in the problem, 0.067 kilograms meter cube per second, pi by 4 d square into L equal to 0.36, n 4.17 meters per second and volumetric efficiency 0.8. So, d square equal to 0.071 and diameter of the cylinder d equal to 0.071 to the power 0.5 equal to 0.266 meter. Then, power required to drive the compressor. For a two-stage compressor, W equal to 2n by n minus 1 P1 V1 into P3 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n minus 1 into 1 by mechanical efficiency. So, substitute numerical values W equal to 2 into 1.25 divided by 1.25 minus 1 into 101.3 into 0.067 into 80 divided by 1 to the power 1.25 minus 1 divided by 2 into 1.25 minus 1 into mechanical efficiency, 1 by mechanical efficiency, 1 divided by 0.75 equal to 49.76 kilowatts. So, the power required to drive the two-stage compressor is 49.76 kilowatts. So, the answer to the problem, power required to drive the compressor is 49.76 kilowatts. Diameter, bore equal to 0.266 meter, stroke length equal to 0.36 meter. Example number 12 from May 2010 question paper, a two-stage compressor with a complete intercooling delivers 10 kg per minute of air at a pressure of 16 bar. The suction occurs at 1 bar and 15 degrees Celsius. The expansion compression process are reversible polytropic with the index n equal to 1.25. Calculate the power required and isothermal efficiency. This is from May 2010 question paper. So, given data, it is a two-stage compressor. Mass of the air equal to 10 kilograms per minute. Delivery pressure is 16 bar. Suction pressure is 1 bar. Suction temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. The index polytropic index equal to n equal to 1.25. So, work done for two-stage compressor with the complete intercooling. W equal to 2n by n minus 1 P1 V1 into P3 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n minus 1. So, P1 V1 equal to MRT1. So, 2n by n minus 1 MRT1 into P3 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by 2n minus 1. So, substitute numerical values 2 into 1.25 divided by 1.25 minus 1 into mass equal to 10 kilograms per minute, 10 divided by 60 into 0.287, R equal to 0.287, T1 equal to 288 into 16 by 1 to the power 1.25 minus 1 divided by 2 into 1.25 minus 1, which is 44 kilowatts. So isothermal work done for the compressor with complete intercooling, W equal to MRT1 into logarithmic of T3 by P1. So 10 by 16 into 0.287 into 288 in logarithmic of 16 by 1 equal to 38.19 kilowatts. So the isothermal efficiency equal to isothermal work divided by the polytropic work into 100, 38.19 divided by 44 into 100 equal to 86.8%. So the answer to the problem, the power required to drive the compressor is 44 kilowatts, isothermal efficiency is 86.8%. Exam number 13 from November 2010 question paper. A two-stage double-acting air compressor operating at 200 rpm takes in air at 1.013 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. The diameter and the stroke of LP cylinder is 35 cm and 38 cm respectively. The stroke of the HP cylinder is the same as the LP cylinder. Clearance of both the cylinders is 4% of the stroke. The LP cylinder discharges air at a pressure of 4.052 bar. The air passes through the intercooler so that it enters the HP cylinder at 27 degrees Celsius and 3.85 bar. Finally, the air is discharged from the compressor at 15.4 bar. The compression and the re-expansion of both the cylinder, the same law, PV to the power 1.2 is constant. Determine the brake power required to run the compressor if mechanical efficiency is 80%, diameter of the HP cylinder and the heat rejected the intercooler. Write down the given data. It is a two-stage double-acting compressor, speed equal to 200 rpm, P1 equal to 1.013 bar, T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, D1 equal to diameter of the LP cylinder, D1 equal to 0.35 meter, L1 equal to L2 equal to 0.38 meter, K equal to 0.04. The clearance ratio is 0.04. P2 equal to 4.052 bar. T3 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. P3 equal to 3.85 bar. P4 delivery pressure of the second compressor, 15.4 bar. N equal to 1.2 and mechanical efficiency is 0.8. So write down the given data. Volumetric efficiency of the LP cylinder. So eta V equal to 1 plus K minus K into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. Substituting numerical values, 1 plus 0.04 minus 0.04 into 4.052 divided by 1.013 to the power 1 by 1.2 equal to 0.913. So septo volume of the LP cylinder, VS1 equal to 2 into pi by 4 D1 square into L into L by 60. So 2 stands for double acting. So 2 into pi by 4 into 0.35 square into 0.38 into 200 by 60 equal to 0.244 metric cubic per second. The actual volume of air handled by the compressor, V1 equal to VS1 into volumetric efficiency. This is equal to 0.244 into 0.913 equal to 0.223 metric cubic per second. So mass of the air handled, M equal to P1 V1 divided by RT1. So 101.3 divided by 0.287. 101.3 into 0.223 divided by 0.287 into 288 equal to 0.273 kilograms per second. So volumetric efficiency of the HP cylinder. So again, 1 plus K minus K into P4 by P3 to the power 1 by N. So 1 plus 0.04 minus 0.04 into 15.4 divided by 3.85 divided by 1 by 1.2 equal to again 0.913. Volume of the air handled by the swept HP compressor, V3 equal to MRT3 divided by P3. So 0.273 into 0.287 into 300 divided by 385 kilopascal, 3.85 bar, which is 385 kilopascal, which is 0.061 metric cube per second. And the swept volume of the HP compressor, VS2 equal to V3 divided by volumetric efficiency, 0.061 divided by 0.913 equal to 0.0668 metric cube per second. Then the VS2 is also equal to 2 times of pi by 4 D2 square into L into N by 60. So 2 stands for double acting, pi by 4 D square into L is the volume, soft volume of the cylinder. So substituting 2 into pi by 4 into D2 square into 0.38 into 200 by 60. So VS2 equal to 0.0668. So 0.0668 equal to 1.99 D2 square. So D2 equal to 0.183 meter. So diameter of the HP compressor or HP cylinder is 0.183 meter. Then the power required to drive the compressor, so W equal to N by N minus 1, MR T1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N, plus P4 by P3 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 2 into 1 by mechanical efficiency. Substituting all numerical values, 1.2 divided by 1.2 minus 1, M equal to 0.273, R equal to 0.287, T1 equal to 300, P2 by P1, 4.052 divided by 1.013 to the power 1.2 minus 1 divided by 1.2, P4 by P3, 15.4 divided by 3.85 to the power 1.2 minus 1 divided by 1.2 minus 2 into 1 by 1.8. So, calculating the power required to drive the compressor is 91.63 kilowatts. Temperature at the end of the compression, T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N. So, 300 into 4.052 divided by 1.013 to the power 1.2 minus 1 divided by 1.2 equal to 378 Kelvin. So, the heat rejected in the intercooler, Q equal to MCP into T2 minus T1. So, M equal to 0.273, Cp we assume 1.004 specific heat of air at constant pressure, 378 minus 300 equal to 21.38 kilojoules per second. So, the answer to the problem, brake power required to run the compressor 91.63 kilowatts, diameter of the HP cylinder D2 equal to 0.183 meter and the heat rejected in the intercooler 21.38 kilowatts. Example number 14 from May 2019 question paper, a three-stage compressor is used to compress air from 1.103 bar to 36 bar. The compression in all these stages follows the law P to the power 1.25 equal to constant. The temperature of the air at inlet to the compressor is 300 Kelvin. Neglecting clearance and assuming perfect intercooling, determine indicated power in kilowatts to deliver 15 meter cube per minute measured at inlet conditions. Intermediate pressure, we take R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, we are given P1 equal to 1.013 bar, P4 equal to, for 3-stage compressor, delivery pressure is P4 equal to 36 bar, N equal to 1.25, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, V1 equal to 15 meter cube per minute, which is 0.25 meter cube per second. So, indicated power for a 3-stage compressor, W equal to 3N by N minus 1, P1 V1, P4 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by 3N minus 1. So, substituting 3 into 1.25 divided by 1.25 minus 1 into 101.3 into 0.25 into 36 divided by 1.013 into the power 1.25 minus 1 divided by 3 into 1.25 minus 1 is equal to 102.1 kilowatts. So, the indicated power equal to 102.1 kilowatts. And the intermediate pressure, so P2 by P1 equal to P3 by P2 equal to P4 by P3. So these are all the pressure ratio, P2 by P1 pressure ratio of the first cylinder, P3 by P2 pressure ratio of the second cylinder, P4 by P3 is the pressure ratio of the third cylinder, which is delivery pressure divided by the suction pressure to the power 1 by 1 by N. So the capital N is the number of stages. So we are given 36 divided by 1.013 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 3.29. So the pressure ratio of the stage is 3.29. Now we calculate the intermediate pressure. So 3.29 into P1 equal to 3.29 into 1.103 equal to 3.33 bar. 3.29 into P2 equal to 3.29 into 3.33 equal to 10.96 bar. 3.29 into P3 equal to 3.29 into 10.96 equal to 36 bar. So the pressure at the end of the first cylinder is 3.33 bar. Pressure at the end of the second cylinder 10.96 bar. Pressure at the end of the third stage is 36 bar. So, these are all the delivery pressure or intermediate pressure. Example number 15 from November 2019 question paper. A multi-stage air compressor used to be designed to elevate the pressure from 1 bar to 125 bar such that the stage pressure ratio will not exceed 4. Determine the number of stages, exact stage pressure ratio and intermediate pressure. So, we are given Pn equal to 125 bar. We do not know how many stages. We have to calculate the how many number of stages. Pn equal to 125 bar, P1 equal to 1 bar and the pressure ratio per stage equal to 4. So, number of calculate the number of stages. Number of stages equal to logarithmic of pressure ratio of the compressor divided by logarithmic of pressure ratio of the stage. So, logarithmic of 125 divided by logarithmic of 4 equal to 4.828 divided by 1.386 equal to 3.48 equal to 4. So, we have taken the stage pressure is 4 and it comes to number of stages equal to 4. So it will be 3.48 is rounded to 4. Now the intermediate pressure will change. The pressure ratio of the stage also will change. It is not exactly 4 right now. Now the exact pressure ratio, n equal to logarithmic of pressure ratio of the compressor divided by logarithmic of pressure ratio of the stage. So this is logarithmic of pressure ratio of the stage equal to logarithmic of pressure ratio of the compressor divided by number of stages, logarithmic of 125 divided by 4 equal to 4.828 divided by 4 equal to 1.207. So the pressure ratio of the stage equal to e to the power 1.027 equal to 3.343. So the pressure ratio of the stage is 3.343. Actual pressure ratio of the stage equal to 3.343, whereas in the example it is given as 4. Now it is corrected to 3.343. So now using the 3.343, the intermediate pressure, first stage, second stage, third stage, fourth stage. So the four stage compressor, inlet pressure for the first stage 1 bar, exit pressure is 3.343 bar. For the second stage, so this outlet pressure will become inlet pressure, 3.343. And the delivery pressure is multiplying by 3.343, 11.175. And here 11.175 is the inlet pressure, 37.358 is the outlet pressure. Fourth stage, 37.358 is the inlet pressure, 127.89 is the exit pressure. So these are the intermediate pressure of the four stage compressor. We stop here. So these are all the books I publish in mechanical engineering, and I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. We'll meet again in another video on the subject in mechanical engineering. Thank you.